Peggy, honey.
Sweetie. I know this is
hey,
scary.
Where are you going? You'll be sorry, Peggy.
Come on, honey. Stay with Mommy. You're going to be okay, Carrie.
Peggy, where do you think you're going?
I'm leaving you, buddy.
Mommy, hurry up. He's coming.
Peggy!
How does the doggy go? How does the kitty go? Grandma goes, kiss, kiss, kiss.
Ooh, Mama has a very long face.
Well, Randy and Donna got engaged today, so not everyone from high school is either married or engaged.
You will, too.
Oh, yeah, right. A 22-year-old with the kid lives with Mom. What a prize.
Oh, poor Mommy gonna be an old maid at 22. Are you hungry?
I just fed her. God. And that goes?
Honey, you're never going to find Mr. Wright watching TV all afternoon. And I have something for you. I think it's going to be just what the doctor ordered. Nancy Greenwich was in this afternoon. She says her whole company is expanding, and they're taking applications for a new training program. So
she just happened to have one in her purse.
So I happened to stop by on my way home. I thought I was doing you a favor.
Thanks.
You're plumbing and electrical. I'd say you're looking at 30 grand easy.
30 grand? Honey, tell me, you have to talk to your wife first.
Well, I'll have a conference with the boss, and I'll give you a call, okay?
Okay.
Thanks, Kevin.
Great. Thanks.
Maybe I can do some of the plumbing work myself.
You're handy, sweetheart, but I didn't marry you for your plumbing skills. Talk to her.
About what?
Mom,
I said she should fill out this application for a training program. Personally, I think that it would lift her spirits to be back into the working world. Don't you think?
Mm-hmm. Mom.
Say something.
What?
I never told her I wouldn't apply. I just don't see why you have to pick up applications for me like I'm some retard.
Man. I was just trying to help.
Excuse me. I need a few more minutes with this.
Oh, sure. No problem.
Hi.
Good morning.
Hi. I'm Carrie Wilson. I'm here for the training seminar.
Oh, certainly.
Can I just fill that out?
That's it.
Hey.
Hey.
Tell him you graduated BYU. And you've been working at the public library. Never check.
I should lie.
No, of course not, but you seem so, panicked.
Oh, I'm not panicked. I'm not. I don't know if I want to stay in Salt Lake. That's all. Do you like working here?
Yeah, so far. Just got started.
Yeah?
Lunch is in a little bit. Maybe I can show you a part of the city that might make you want to stay.
No, thanks. I have stuff to do. Okay.
No sweat. I'm not a bad guy. There's nothing up my sleeves. I just, got a good vibe for you, that's all.
So, where's this really cool place?
Come on, then.
She goes down to get a job, she comes back gaga over a construction worker.
Got a hell of a smile on her face. It's a big plus.
Okay, so you didn't kiss him?
No.
But you gave him your phone number?
Of course I did. It's too good to be true. I was totally ready to give up, and then there he was.
Oh, right on. And he's, like, totally cool with the whole Jenna thing?
Well, we didn't do the whole tell each other everything conversation yet.
I cannot wait to lay eyes on this dream man.
Oh my God, you are going to die. You are going to be so
dead. Kids, you're going to drown the cactus.
Stop it.
Hey, Louise.
Hi.
Feeling good?
Yeah, we're great. I need some new hedge clippers. Mike leaves them out and they get rusty.
You really okay?
Oh, Peggy, I just came in to get some new hedge clippers.
You know, I don't do much counseling anymore, Louise, but I'm still in the book.
Peggy, I put off coming in because I didn't want you bugging me with restraining orders and agencies. I'm fine. Mike's fine. I'll take these.
Okay, just make sure somebody looks at that eye, huh?
Getting real good. Is everybody down in here?
Oh, is that that new police show? I love that.
Yeah, it's so cool. Hey, Dad, can I go on the hunting trip this year? You said when I got bigger.
No, I said when you were 12, Stevie.
But, Dad...
Hey, besides, your mom's probably going to have something to say about that.
I heard that.
Jesse, try and get some of the husks in the sack, not on the floor.
Slob, get a life.
Hello, somebody? Table needs setting.
Well, I'm working on the calls, honey.
I'm Husky. I'm babysitting.
Get your sister.
Oh, my God.
Can you get the door?
I'm getting it.
Ah. You must be little Stevie. I hear you're a big hockey fan, huh? Wow. Now this little one's a heartbreaker, huh? Oh, I'm Gene. You're Walter?
Yes.
And this must be Jess.
Gene, was Carrie expecting you?
Well, it was just a spontaneous thing. And I just thought I'd drop by.
Gene's here. He's talking to Dad.
Okay. I'll be right there.
So I hear you're planning to do some work in your house.
Yeah, we're doing it. We're fixing up the basement.
Okay.
Yeah, excuse me, adding a couple of rooms, you know?
You know, I'm a pretty good carpenter.
Is that right?
Yeah, maybe we can take a look.
Sure. Yeah, come on.
Also, I used to work for a plumbing contractor.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. Right here.
Ah, oh, well, you must be Gene.
Yeah.
I'm Peggy.
Oh, hi. Nice to meet you.
Hi. Well, will you join us for supper?
Well, honestly, Mrs. Pomeroy, I had this fantasy about taking Carrie out for a slice of pizza. So, can I take a rain check?
Sure you can, Gene.
Great.
Yeah, I was just gonna show Gene the work we're doing down in the basement.
Good.
Okay, thank you, though.
Downstairs.
Do you see how great he is?
Oh, he's darling, honey. I just wish he'd call first. I believe he'd call it.
Mom.
Respect for
Mom.
The family.
What? Mom, you'd be nice.
I'm always nice.
Please.
Well, there's no reason we have to throw your money away on a contractor, Walter. I mean, you and I can do about 90% of this work ourselves. I mean, it might be fun, you know? Yeah, I know. I mean, I'm kind of rushing Carrie. Thing is, you know, I'm the type of person that when I feel things really strong, it's hard for me to hold back. And, I mean, the first minute I met her, right, I just, you know, I had this sense.
Gene, I've known Carrie practically her whole life.
Hey, you guys. Hi.
Hey. You look great.
Thanks. I want you to meet Jenna. Say hi, Gene.
Hi, Gene.
Hi. I already met your brothers and sisters, and your mom's cool. You know, it was like Mama Lion time.
Well, Steve and Jesse are my half-brothers, and Jenna is my little girl.
Wow. She's so beautiful. Hey. Any dad in the picture?
Oh, no, he's total history.
Oh, yeah? Come on, my little beauty. Where'd you get the bear, huh? Ah, it looks like a nice bear. Yeah.
Hey, just wait, please. Could you take this outside? Thank you.
Hey,
snag some chips with your beer.
Oh, that'll be great.
Oh, thanks, Peg.
So, Jean.
Jenna, let's go outside with Stevie and Jesse. Come on.
Family here in Salt Lake?
Oh, well, half of them. I live with my mom. Don't see my dad much. He lives up in Montana.
Hmm. So, you ready to go for pizza?
We don't have what you guys have. You know, he's a bull rider. He's got a big, you know, spread up there.
You know, remember that dude ranch up in Montana?
He's a big star. He's a star on the rodeo circuit.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I interrupted.
I lost my train of thought.
You were talking about the rodeo circuit.
What?
About your dad in Montana. And
just drop it. Just drop it. All right? Mm-hmm. Listen. It's been a pleasure, folks.
Hi.
What just happened?
I don't know. He was as nice as could be when we were downstairs. Something about big old scary mama lions makes a fella feel nervous, I guess.
I guess.
So I got engaged to Roger after I got pregnant. And I like it, but I didn't make my mom happier.
Don't you love him?
I thought I did, but I found out he'd been cheating on me the whole time. So I moved back home.
I don't know how anybody could do that to you. But you didn't answer my question. Did you love him?
I don't know if you call that love. I mean, whatever it is, I don't feel it now.
So you're 100% positive about that?
What do you mean?
Well, what I mean is, I'm not Roger the Dodger. Now, when I give my heart away, that's that. I'm crazy glue. No, wait. You know what? When you do that?
What?
You look so cute because your lip like puckers up.
So, Mr. Crazy Glue, can I go to the ladies' room? Am I allowed out of your sight?
You know what? I'll give you 5 minutes, and if you're not back, I'm coming after you.
I'd never give up, Peggy.
Honey, how'd you find me?
Who cares? You see, you and me, we's going down in flames together. Just like it was always meant to be.
No!
It's okay. It's just the dream. You just have to dream again. It's okay.
Thank you.
is not here. She's talking to him on the phone. I mean, it's getting so that I can't go to the bathroom without bumping into him. He's taken over her whole life, our lives. Am I crazy?
Not since you've noticed. Have you seen the hand cleaner?
Yeah. Oh. Talk to me.
I know what you mean. It's just that type. Wears his heart on his sleeve. Daughter's in love, Peg. Better get used to it.
I'm gonna take Gina's lunch, do a couple errands, and then I'll be right back.
But do I tell Gina that Walter's not gonna be here next Saturday? He's going to that flower show down in Cedar City.
Okay.
So, Scotty tells me that the whole gang's gonna be taking Don and Randy down to Lamar's that night.
Yeah.
You going, right? Scotty's dying to meet him. You guys have been kind of standoffish.
No, we just might have other plans, is all. I mean, besides, Scott is too possessive anyway. I gotta go.
Friends like Don and Randy are like gold, honey.
Okay, Mom. What is it? What's your case against Jean?
I don't have a case. There's just something that I see that I recognize.
There's always something.
Honey, I'm not trying to tell you what to do. I'm just suggesting that a healthy balance is a good thing. I'm sure everybody will love Jean.
Okay, I gotta go.
First met, you said, oh, my friends are boring. I mean, why are we even bringing this up again, huh?
Jean, whoa. I've known Donna since third grade. I mean, I didn't mean that I ever wanted to see her again. And besides, a healthy balance is a good thing, okay?
Look, don't pin this on me, all right? If you want to go to some party, go. But I don't want to spend my time with a bunch of boring provincial types at some cowboy bar. It's not my scene, all right?
Fine.
My theory is he is so incredibly disgusting, she is afraid to bring him around
us. No, it isn't that. It's just that we're in the gloom of romance. Toast? To you guys? We love last flavor.
Cha-cha.
Scotty, I don't know what to do.
Come on, please dance with me.
I know, and it'll never happen again. Can't believe I hurt you. Every bone in your body wants to believe. I know. It's the name of a shelter. It's not exactly the Ritz, but you'll be safe there until he's in jail.
How did you get away?
When I started thinking that he was going to hurt my daughter, Carrie. Then I got ruthless. Couldn't run for my own life, but I'd do anything for hers. Strange, aren't we?
I'm afraid he's gonna find me. I don't think I can stand up to him.
You'll find it. Yes, you will. You'll find it in there. If I did, anybody can. And I got a great guy. Just keep talking through it. And don't shut us out. Where I will.
Can Mr. Hardhat do this?
No way.
We gotta run up to Hollywood, you and I.
Oh my God.
I am so sorry. Excuse me. I'm gonna get some yourself, okay?
Sorry.
She's a hot one, your partner.
Thanks.
You got something going, huh? Because I might be in love.
Scotty, are you tired? Gene.
This is Gene?
What are you doing here?
Well, I can ask you the same question, followed up by what are you doing with Roy Rogers here?
Scotty?
Wrong road, Gene.
I'm not talking to you, all right?
Do you follow me?
We're out of here, Carrie.
I'm not going anywhere with you. Did you follow me? You followed me.
Right. Easy, pal. She's not interested. You got it? Why don't you just go on home?
Hey, hell, you're out of here.
Still down here in Cedar Creek. I know, Peg, I know. But Nolan's roses are unbelievable this year, and I want to stay over and see the orchids, so I'm going to spend tonight, okay? See you tomorrow. Love you. Bye.
Me. Next minute, you got your hands all over the guys.
Mom, I can handle this.
Carrie, get inside.
You know what, Peggy? Your daughter's telling you to mind your own business.
My daughter is my business. And don't you ever presume to set limits on my business. Don't get the hell out of here before the police show up.
Oh, this is beautiful.
Sorry, honey, but somebody had to take control.
Yeah, and you just couldn't wait to be the one.
Jesse, what happened here?
It's not trying to kill us. Why do you always have to exaggerate everything?
I don't know why you're yelling at me.
I am not the one.
I am not the one that tore up the lawn. I am not the one that grabbed your arm and twisted it until you were in tears.
I know. I'm not saying he was right. I am not excusing him. I am simply saying it was my problem and you should have let me handle it.
Okay, so I should have apologized for stepping on your toes.
I should have
done that. But it's that jealousy. It's that need to control.
Oh, yes. It's all part of the usual pattern.
What's that supposed to mean?
The dreaded Buddy Wilson syndrome. Isn't that what you're getting to?
Are you talking about Jean's re-landscaping the front yard?
I'm gonna get some air.
You gonna say something?
Okay, here it is, Peg. Jean may not be great son-in-law material. What he did was dangerous. But I don't think he'd hurt anyone.
You weren't here last night, Walter.
That's true.
It's not just the mailbox, it's the way he was with her.
No one's arguing about that, Peg. It's just that at a certain point, you gotta back off and let them mess up their own lives.
Just for once, Walter, could you not take the path of least resistance? So he's saving us a bundle.
Listen, I don't need to get all worked up to have a point of view. Now, I don't like to say this, but Carrie's right. On this particular subject, you are not the most objective person in the world.
Oh, I see. So I'm reading into Jean's behavior. I'm obsessed with the past.
No, not obsessed, maybe, but you did have the dream again a few nights ago. And you still hide this.
to the bed every time I go out of town.
Right. Right, I don't want my daughter to wake up with nightmares. I don't want my granddaughter being yanked out of her home in the middle of the night.
I understand. But you've done a great job with Carrie. I know, I've been here. Put a little trust in that. Show a little faith in her.
Okay.
Yep, Jean acts like a real jerk. But Mom thinks every guy is like my dad.
Hi, are you Oz?
You're Carrie, right?
Yeah.
I'm Maggie Shepherd, Jean's mom. And Jean, he asked
did
me if
I... Did you see what he did to our mailbox?
You know, if I may be so bold, Carrie, Gene's an extremely unusual person. He's got a temper, but he's really kind and loving and smart. He's just crazy about you, Carrie, and he's suffering real bad. We're hoping maybe you come over and have some lunch and let him make his amends. You know?
Here's my famous chicken salad. Water chestnuts and hearts of palm.
Okay, so you're a great chef. What about how you acted last night and how you treated me and my friend? My arm still hurts.
She wants an apology, Jean, and I don't blame her.
There's one thing I'm not gonna apologize about, okay? And that's how I feel about you. I mean, I never expected to feel this way, and it scares me.
So?
So when I see some guy in some fancy cowboy shirt with his hands all over you, I'm gonna react.
Yeah.
Okay, I could have handled it better, I guess. I just love you so much. I really do. I want to marry you someday. I mean, someday soon. I really want a little house, you know, for you, me, and Jenna. Carrie, I'll do anything. I'm signing up for counseling tomorrow morning, you know? Listen, if you want to walk out of here right now, I'm not going to stop you. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. I'm really sorry.
I know what you're thinking, but it's my life, and we're actually very happy.
I've been perfectly polite to Jean. I haven't said a word to you, but my thoughts are my own personal business.
He's doing really great, by the way, in case you hadn't noticed.
Hi. Walter wants a brew. You know, Peggy, things are going real well down there. You should come check it out.
I'll be down there soon.
Oh, great.
Oh, no. Coconut. You know what? You're back.
Got a second, Scotty?
Sure, Ms. P. What's up?
You've been missing out at the house lately.
I feel kind of weird just, like, you know, butting into your family business.
You've been butting in since you were 12, last guy. Why are you and her other friends staying away?
Honestly?
Yeah.
Okay, the other night at Lamar's, he followed her there, and he was, like, totally wired and, like, psycho man. And he was seriously gonna hurt me and Carrie if Randy hadn't jumped in and stopped him.
Did you pull those papers for me?
So I got a restraining order. It's better. He keeps calling, and I've learned to hang up. Anyway, let's talk about your problem. I hope this isn't too much to ask.
I owe you, Peg. So what's this guy's name?
Shepherd. Gene Shepherd. I don't know his address. I just know that he works on construction at MDT Data Works. Carrie knew I was doing this.
So what makes you think he's been in trouble with the law?
Call it animal instinct.
Here we go.
You know what I just realized? He did his time in Montana. Home of the bull-riding father.
Peg, you were right about him. I was wrong. I just don't think he'd get a guy fired, that's all.
Look, harassing a woman, charming. Hosts ask him to leave. You would, too. He goes home, finds a knife, comes back and stabs the man 11 times. I'm supposed to sweep this under the rug?
And he went to jail. He did his time.
God! I want this man out of commission. I don't want him to have a leg to stand on. I don't want him to have a cent to buy gas to take my daughter out with. I don't know. I feel so helpless.
Listen, my car will be ready till 6. Can you pick me up?
Yes, you better go. You're late.
Now, I was thinking about what I said.
My mom died. I mean, I don't see how much difference it can be living at your mom's.
Oh, really different. Mom's nuts about you. Your mother won't give an inch, you know? And it's only gonna be temporary anyways till we find our own place.
You just... It's a huge decision. Just give me a little second.
Say no more. Offer stands. Hi, Pumpkin.
Hi.
Shepherd.
Yeah, give me 1 minute, sir. I'm talking to my lady, all right?
Miss Shepherd. I knew there's something I didn't like about you. You lied on your job application. Pick up your check in my office.
Who the hell's trashing me?
It's exactly the same thing if you're coming after my daughter.
Talk to my mom, said she'd love to have it until we get our own place.
Gene, come on, we haven't really even talked.
Of course it's gonna take a lot longer now since some vindictive bitch
trying to ruin my reputation. Just calm down there,
Gene. Nobody's taking my granddaughter anywhere, and you're not going anywhere with this man.
Listen to you, did you hear her? It is my life. You cannot try and destroy the man I love. You got him fired, Mom. You hear me? You got him fired. You are totally out of control.
Okay, that's it.
You are totally...
That's it, let's just go inside, talk about this like adults.
Don't patronize me, Walter, all right? You people are not my friends. That was a major miscalculation in my department, wasn't it? Here I was spending all my free time in your basement bringing happiness to your daughter, accepting Jenna as one of my own. As one of my own.
I can see right through you. This man has a record, honey, for slicing up a man because he asked him to leave a party. I'm sorry you had to find out this way. You knew this?
Come on, baby, let's get out of here.
Get Jen out of that car and get her inside.
Hey, you know what? Bad move. Because if she has to make a choice, I win.
Back off.
I win. Stop being such a bully. Get in the car. I'm gonna pack my stuff. Why couldn't have you just let things alone?
I'll look after Jenna. Go.
Carrie?
Okay.
You been checking for aphids?
Of course. I saw them at the carnival on Saturday night. They were waiting in line to take Jenna on the Ferris wheel. Jean actually tried to be a human being to me.
How does she seem, Scotty? Did she look like she was guarded, like she was trying to hide something? Was Jenna depressed?
Actually, they seemed really happy.
Check it out. Not too shabby, huh?
Fine.
New jacket. Deer hunting this weekend. Peg? Am I busting up a funeral or something?
He saw her. He thinks she's fine.
Well, good. I'm glad she's fine. Jean's not fine, though. Got some particularly aggravating news from the plumber this morning. Seems old Jean doesn't know his butt from a bowling ball.
Didn't surprise me for a second. All my life, I've never been separated from her like this. There's no messages at home?
No.
Well, then I guess I'll have to call her.
Well, it's not like she won and you lost, you know?
You know, it's murder, realizing that you're not needed. It's like somebody just took your insides and scooped them out. Plus, I hate admitting I might be wrong.
You might be right. Doesn't matter. The fact is, she's happy, you're miserable. What's the obvious conclusion?
Pick up the phone.
That's why I married you. Good for your color.
Hey, little one. Hey.
Oh, hey,
honey. Here we go. Hey, buddy.
Hey, Stevie. Hey, hey Jesse.
Hey, Jean.
Oh.
Hey, Carrie. Hey, Spring.
I stole it. I mugged some lady in the parking lot. Ripped it right off her finger. What? It's a joke, Peggy. I'm just, you know, I'm just trying to light things up around here.
Hi, Jean.
Mm-hmm. Alter.
Hey, Jean, what'd you bring?
Well, that's my famous chicken salad.
So, we're still at Jean's mom's, but, everything's cool. She's a really good person.
Jean working?
Off and on, but the really good news is that I got a job.
No.
Yes, right on!
Carrie?
I was not ignoring you.
Call it what you want, Carrie. All I know, I was standing there with my face hanging out with nobody to talk to.
I have not seen them for 3 months. I thought everyone was very nice to you,
oh,
Dean.
Oh, come on, Carrie, surface, all right? Now that I got the prize, they want to be my best friend, huh?
They want to work it out for me. Why can't you see it that way?
Why can't I see it that way? I'll tell you what. Phonies, Carrie. All of them phonies.
If it was up to you, the whole world would just disappear except me and your mother.
You know what? You know what? Look at it. Since your baby's asleep, why don't you and I have a little fun?
Because your mother is coming home.
Wait a second. You know what? You used to like it dangerous. You know what? You used to like it period.
You are such a pig when you're drunk. Yes, and you're always drunk.
I'm always drunk.
Yes.
Always drunk?
Yes, you're always drunk.
Get away from me! Come on, baby, we're okay. Okay? Here we go. Jean's car. Is your car seat? Okay? Come on, honey, it's gonna be okay. It's okay. Okay, we're gonna go see Grandma. Okay?
Get out of the car! Get out of the car!
Oh, Jean!
my daughter in there.
All right, sir. You're going inside. Go ahead.
What'd you hit?
I'm Jean's mom. I called the police.
Have you any idea how sick your son is?
Jean feels so bad about this, he could die.
I'll bet he does.
Excuse me, ma'am.
I just got home. I was working late.
They'll hold him for 48 hours, but she's going to need to come down to the DA's office the next day or so to file charges.
Yeah, I know the drill. We'll be there. Okay, now, I don't mean to be a nag about this, but you really got to get out of bed and get to the DA's office, honey. See what's happening.
Look, this is how he's did, okay? He's already had 2 convictions for assault. He gets 1 more, and he does real time.
Is that the way you see it?
Yes, that's the way I see it.
Is your memory that short? I was there. I saw what happened to
you. Mom, it is over between us. I'm not stupid. I just feel really bad about putting him away for the rest of his life. He's a person. He's not a felon. He's a person. He's someone I loved.
I know it's hard. But this is something I know a lot about, honey.
I know that.
That in situations like this,
I know.
That it's the best thing for everybody, including Jean, by the way, is to get some distance between the two.
I know that.
If you don't press charges, it's like an invitation, Carrie. He'll be back in a flash. And the stakes get higher every time you let him get away with this. I do not intend to bury my daughter.
Okay. You gotta give me some space on this, okay? I'm going.
I didn't think you'd come.
Don't do this.
Don't what?
Don't tell me how sorry you are. Promise me how it's gonna be perfect from here on out. No, listen to me. The only reason I came down here was to tell you that I'm not going to see you anymore.
I only have myself to blame. I was so lucky. I mean, you're the most incredible woman in the world. It's a love most people only dream about. And I lose control just once.
It wasn't once, Jane. We're like oil and water.
You don't mean that. Carrie, I was there. Just give me an ultimatum. I'll stop drinking. I'll go to counseling for real this time. This is life and death for me. Think about it. I can't live without you. I can't live without you.
I just don't feel right about this, Peg. I think I should go out there and tell Johnny and Rob that I can't make it this year. It's no big deal.
No. You get 1 weekend per year with your brothers. You're going.
Carrie went to the DA's office this morning. We'll be fine.
But...
No. I mean it.
All right.
Shoot me if you ever see me in high-heeled sneakers.
Don't change the subject.
Enough.
He really got under your skin yesterday, didn't he?
Of course he did.
Do you want to know what I think? Or do you just want to hear, okay, Carrie, I understand, Carrie, because I think You really should have pressed charges.
I don't want to be lectured. I need someone to talk to, not this cut him off at the knees thing. You sound like my mother.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
He claims that the two of you have this, like, totally cosmic, totally mystical, like, 1940 Clark Gable movie kind of romance, right? Well, that's all about him. I mean, really, what's in it for you?
Passion. I mean, when it's good, it's so incredible.
Well, is it really passion? Or is it... was it like when you bang your head against a wall? I mean, God, it feels so good when you stop. Carrie, you know that I love you. And a lot of other people love you too. And none of us feel that it's necessary to change a single thing about you. And Jean's all, oh, I love you, but I expect you to do everything I say every time I say it.
I know. I mean, I've been a bad friend and even mom. I'm sorry. I love you.
It's okay. You know, he's not going to just go away. Maybe you should tell him that you found somebody else.
I see. 1 minute she's crying in my face. And the next minute, she's back fooling around with you again. What you got that I don't got, huh, big boy?
Gene, I told you I was gonna let him go! Stop! Gene! Gene, let him go! Gene, let him go! God. You're crazy!
Yeah, crazy enough to get my heart for a piece of garbage like you!
Stop it! Stop it! You are pathetic! I was just sitting here talking to him about giving you a second chance.
Yeah, I'm mulling it over with Dream Boy over here.
My mother was dead on about you. I cannot believe how long it took me to see that. You stay away from me. I can put you in jail for a very, very long time.
Hey.
Hi.
Scotty come into work today?
Yep.
Jenna's asleep. Dinner's at 6, and Walter should be home by then.
Okay.
Everything okay?
Yeah, I'm gonna get that downstairs. Everything's fine. No, there's nothing to talk
about. No, listen, Carrie, you gotta let me come over. I gotta talk to you.
No.
Listen, I know you're not in love with Scotty. I just lost my head, all right?
No, it's not that, okay? It's just that I've met someone else, and it's not Scotty, and he's coming over, and I gotta go.
What do you want, Gene?
I'm here to prove you're right, Peggy. I'm as bad as you thought. Bad as your worst nightmare and then some.
If you're here to see Carrie, she's gone out.
What do you mean? I just talked to her.
So that was you on the phone.
Well, it had to be the way she stormed out of here. Don't take this the wrong way, but what are you doing out of jail?
I got out early.
Really? What was that, time out for good behavior?
No, I broke out, you know, killed a couple guards. Don't lie to me, Peggy. I can see your car outside.
Jane, calm down. She couldn't get the car started. She took the truck. You want me to tell her that you stopped by?
I don't think you understand. You know why? I'm not here just stopping by. I'm here to kill you and kill every other living thing in this house. Get the picture?
I hear you. But you picked a lousy day to do it because I'm the only one home. So why don't you go on home before any real trouble starts, okay? I'll have Carrie call you. Must be a wrong number.
Wrong number.
No, I didn't wait for a response. What do you think?
Have you thought about going to see the DA again?
Well, I don't know.
Hold on just a second. Hi.
How you doing?
Hey, you guys. Hey. Goodbye.
Sorry, Carrie, I had a customer. Hello?
You better stay where you are and not make any noise! I'm gonna kill your mom! Got it? Huh?
If he wanted to kill us, it would be dead already. He wants something else. Where's Jenna?
What are you two whispering about?
I was just telling her to stay cool. I think that's what we all need to do.
Oh, I see. Oh, sorry. We're gonna talk the wacko down. Still think you're running the show, don't you? Pig on my heart.
Gene, I know I'm the one you blame for everything.
There's a lot of blame to go around. Don't you worry about that. So... why don't you come over? Huh?
Who?
What do you mean, who?
Oh, what I told you on the phone that I was seeing someone.
Yes? Why don't you quit trying to protect them?
Gene, there was no one to protect, okay? I made it up. I knew you'd have a hard time letting go, and I...
Oh, really? So I guess if we're not waiting for somebody to come over, there's no reason why I shouldn't start shooting people now. Okay.
Carrie, I think it's time that you... tell Jane the truth.
I'm seeing someone. I am.
Do I know him? When'd you meet him?
His name is Bob.
Bob? Where does Bob live?
I met him in high school, okay? I just called him yesterday. I thought it would help me get over you. Please, okay?
We gotta go for help.
I think we should just wait till Dad gets home. Dad might not be home for hours. See that window over there? If we could get that wood off, we could get out. But he said he'd kill Mom if he made any noise.
Stay if you want. I have to go for help.
Wait up.
Bob. What a phony you turned out to be. Here I thought you were this sweet angel with this little kid who just wanted a man to make a real commitment. But you know what? I'll be remembered as the fool who fell in love with the wrong woman. And you know what? There's no shame in that. But you'll be remembered as a loser chick who didn't know what she wanted.
Gene, let me say something.
You know what, Peggy? You talk too much. Did anyone ever tell you that?
You can shoot me if you have to, but you have to know this. I did everything in my power to try to break you two up. But Carrie was always loyal. She stuck by you.
So what's your point?
The point is that she gave you everything she had. It's not her fault things didn't work out.
She led me on.
Led you on?
Yeah, she did.
Oh, Gene. Last time she saw you, you tried to kill her. Do you really think that she was going to welcome you with open arms?
You know, Peggy, she jerked you around too. When you thought she was spilling her guts to the DA, she was kissing these lips through the glass while you were home babysitting. Weren't you, Carrie? Weren't you?
Look, I don't know that there's someone there, but this guy has been stalking her.
Unless you know he's there now, we don't routinely just send an officer.
What, don't you have any cars in the area that you can just send by the house?
Please,
I mean, the guy has a record.
Sir.
Here, look outside. Yeah. Here.
Jane, I want to check on Jenna.
Sit still.
Pull harder.
You guys want to come in for a beer? I'm sure Peg would be glad to see you.
Oh, I better take a rain check. Terry will pitch fit.
Tell us guys how to put some of that salt in jerky.
Please. Please, I need to see Jenna.
Peggy, you stay here. We're gonna keep an eye on you. You come with me.
Dad!
Dad!
Dad! Over here, Dad!
Where's the door lock?
Is your gun loaded?
What?
Is your gun loaded?
Don't even think about it! Don't! You get over there. You see the gun? There you go. Yep. Get in the living room. Stay!
Don't
underneath! Gene, whatever it is, we can work it out. What do you want? Just tell me. What do you want? Just tell me what you want.
Where are the boys?
It's Scotty! Scotty! Scotty, over here, it's us! Stevie and Jesse!
What are you guys doing down there?
Gene's inside, he got a gun! He's gonna kill them!
Okay. Okay, look out, I'm gonna get you guys out, alright? Back up, back up. Alright, come on, let's go. Okay, watch your back. Be quiet, alright?
Yes.
Alright, go ahead. Let's go. We're gonna go call the police, alright?
The faster I get the guns, the faster the girls get out of the pantry. In the bag, Walter. In the bag. That's right.
Where are my boys, Jim?
Shut up! You don't understand, Walter. I'm gonna search the house anyways. So let's just make this a little faster. Show me where the guns are.
In the hall. Just tell me where my son...
Shut up!
And even when we weren't getting along, he always made me feel like I was the most important person in the world.
I know, baby.
I'm not like you. I'm not strong or proud or smart. I'm not sorry.
Honey,
I'm sorry.
Don't do that to yourself, honey. Before I left your father, you remember all those times we tried to get away?
Yeah, because I remember he always came after us.
Yeah. That's what I told you. That's what I wanted you to know.
You sure fooled me.
Come on, Tom Hanks. Now put the gun in the bag. You had a real soft spot for me, didn't you, Mary Walter?
45. But first. Yeah, I thought you were smart. Real smart, Slick.
Where's the ammo? Where's the ammo?
Here. I still think you're a really unusual person, Jane.
Oh, I'd leave him, all right. He'd be threatening all kinds of insanity. But then a few days would go by, and I'd start missing him again. See? I was exactly like you. I thought he was the only one in the whole world that really knew me.
You know what I see here, Jean? I see a guy who's out on a limb, doesn't know how to get back. I think you want to put the gun down, but you don't know how. I just want you to know, Jean, that it'd be a lot easier than you think. Because Carrie would never hold a grudge. Neither would Peg.
Oh, cute, Walter. You know what? Your wife is the bitch from hell. If it wasn't for her, Carrie and I would be totally happy. Understand that? Is there any more guns around the house?
No.
And, so I'd call him, and he'd be all sheepish, full of promises. And I'd go back. It was my choice, honey.
How'd you break away then? What happened?
I got pregnant again. I had this fantasy that it would bring us together. And then one night, he beat me so bad. Several days later, I miscarried. I was 7 months pregnant at the time.
I'm so sorry.
No, honey, no.
I'm so sorry.
No, honey. There's just some mistakes that you would move heaven and earth to spare your kids.
All right, get out of the closet! Come on, get out of the closet! All right. Let me have the ammo.
Take it easy. Take it easy.
Out. You stay here. Stay here.
I'll distract him. You get the shotgun.
He's got the 45.
We gotta try.
Shut up. Stop whispering. Go sit on the couch. Sit down.
Mommy, I
woke up.
About Jenna, Jane. This little girl loves you. She thinks you're practically her daddy. You're gonna blow away her whole family in front of her. You're gonna blow her away.
Shut up!
Think about it, Jane. If you kill this little girl or any one of us in front of her, nobody will ever remember anything that drove you to...
Don't push it, Peggy!
You gotta let her go.
We've got a possible hostage situation, Lieutenant. We've got a child and four adults in the house. One of the adults is armed and making threats.
Why don't you guys tell me what happened?
Well, we were just hanging around playing air hockey. And all of a sudden, Gene, that's my sister's boyfriend, he showed up with a gun and he said he was going to shoot everybody.
He's got a record, aggravated assault.
Go to his house, bring back anybody.
Lieutenant!
You can find.
Somebody's coming out! Hey, what are you doing? Get over and get on your knees! You two, on your knees! Come on! Hank, on your knees! Put the phone away. You know what? I guess it's time to start killing people. Too bad Bob couldn't be in our little circle of friends. You know what, Carrie? I guess you have to wait for your funeral, because I'm on board. Okay, who wants to go first? Who wants to go first? Peggy?
No! Oh, God!
Oh, no!
Okay, guys, here's what I need to know. When Gene said he was going to kill everybody, was he serious or, you know, was he just making noise?
He was serious.
Miss Shepherd, it's the police.
It's open. He just didn't have a chance. Oh, my God. He's such an angry boy ever since his daddy died.
She's with you now?
Yeah, we're on our way.
Go ahead and read me the note.
This world holds too much pain for me, and I can't live in it without my beloved Carrie. I've tried everything I could. Now death is our only
option. We'll finally be together. You were a great mom, and I always loved you. Please forgive me, your son, Gene.
She says, please. Do what she says.
Establish a direct line with the house. So all you have to do is go to the phone and hang it up, Gene.
Okay, the only entrance apart from the front and back doors are the garage and here.
What about the way the boys got out? Can we get a man in there?
Lieutenant Washington, SWAT team's here.
Okay, let me know when they're in position.
Will do, ma'am.
Gene, there are a lot of people out here who want to help you, but we can't do anything without a phone.
He's on the line, Lieutenant.
Gene, Lieutenant Washington here.
Keep everyone back, or I'm going to start shooting.
I'm taking care of that right now, Gene.
Okay, Gene? Listen.
I want to work this out with you, but you have to understand something up front, Gene. If you start shooting,
this thing is going to get ugly real fast.
So just relax, okay? Gene? Is there anybody you want to talk to, Gene? Just let me know.
Everything's happened so fast. Let me think.
Hold that position.
All right, Miss Shepard. Thank you for coming, Mrs. Shepard. You know what's going on, I take it.
Uh-huh.
I'm sorry, we've got to stay very low. Does your son have a history of suicide attempts?
Yes. He took a lot of pills one time, and he wrecked his car by driving into a bus.
Okay, I know what I want. I want to talk to Bob.
We're going to try to find him, Gene, but in the meantime, your mother's here.
She wants to talk to you.
What's the matter, Gene?
Why the hell did you drag her down here?
Gene, she wanted to come. She's very
worried about you.
This whole thing is screwed up. Listen, can you, just tell her I can't talk to her right now, okay? And tell her, but make sure you tell her that I love her. I love her, and,
Gene?
That none of this is her fault.
Gene, is there anyone you will talk to?
Yeah, I want to talk to Bob! Bob!
You understand English?
Bob! Huh?
Try to stay calm, Gene. What's Bob's last name?
All right, okay. What's Bob's last name?
He hasn't got a last name. He hasn't got a last name because he doesn't exist. I made the whole thing up.
Gene, are you there, Gene?
All right, Hang on one second. Are you telling me straight? You tell me straight, Carrie. Is there or is there not a Bob?
I was never seeing anyone named Bob.
Gene, what's happening, Gene?
Alright, so you're talking to Scotty then, huh?
No, it's not anybody, Gene. I made it up because you were gonna kill my mom. Don't you get it?
I am not dead! I am not dead! I am not stupid!
I've been completely faithful to you the entire time. You went crazy over nothing. Nothing.
Gene? Listen to me. Why don't you just give me the guns and we'll all walk out of here together? You haven't hurt anyone yet. You're not a criminal, please.
You have to pick up the phone.
You know what? We're gonna take a little field trip.
Why?
Why? Because I said so! You understand? Huh? Do you mind? Come on!
Want to hurt you.
You two in the basement, come on!
Why do we have to be separated?
Because I want to be alone with Carrie, all right?
Your mother's out here. She's been telling us how you took care of her when you
get the phone.
Died.
Put my mom on the phone.
Gene, honey?
Listen, Mom, I'm really sorry they dragged you down into all this.
Honey, you don't want to hurt anybody. That's not the real you.
I know. But listen, Mom, you gotta be strong for me. I don't understand why someday.
Everybody hold your positions and stand by.
I didn't hear the door lock. My 22 is under the mattress. I'm going up to get it.
Peg, you've never even fired that guy.
Oh.
Yeah, I guess so.
Honey, these last few months since you've been back meant so much to me. I have so much I want to make up to you.
Listen, Mom, it's not you, it's not me, it's them. No, I know that now. You know, I mean, none of this would have mattered if Carrie would just gave me the commitment that I needed. I mean, that's all it would have taken, you know? Huh? I don't blame you, okay?
Gene. Yes! Tell her the truth.
If you want to talk to her, you wait your turn!
She's trying to distract me, Mom. The only one thing about her is she has a real temper. I mean, I know you think she's safe.
He's bleeding to death.
Blame me. It's not my fault. It's all your fault. This whole thing is your fault.
Is that what it is? It's my fault. Well, maybe those pretty boy eyes of yours don't see what I do.
What do you see?
That gutless brat. Waving a gun around trying to be somebody. Well, your mama forgot to tell you something. You're nobody. You could kill all of us and you'd still be nobody! Enough! You cannot kill my mother! You kill me!
Shut up!
You kill me!
Shut up! You're stupid! Come on!
Lieutenant Washington here. Get back to the telephone, please.
If you try to get out of here, I'll shoot you through the floorboards! You got that, Peggy?
We don't want to hurt you, Jude.
You get over there.
Your mother's out.
Get over there!
She's bleeding to death!
No, death comes to us all, doesn't it?
God, it makes me sick to think of ever you were such a twisted,
shut up!
Disgusting
thing! Shut up! Shut up!
That's the word. Anyone gets a clear shot, take it.
You see what happens when you're threatening everybody? Nobody listens to you. Nobody.
You know what?
What?
Maybe I should put my money where my mouth is.
You go ahead.
You know, I can still let you walk out of here.
Don't you dare jerk me around, Gene. I'm so past kissing up to you. But you know what? You know what? I'll do anything you want to save Walter and my mother. Anything.
Well, forget about old Peggy, because she's history.
We got Mrs. Pomeroy.
Lieutenant Washington here.
Are you all right?
I'm all right, but my husband's bleeding to death.
Can you tell me where you are in the house?
I'm locked in the basement. How are my boys? How's Jenna?
They're fine.
Oh, God.
Mrs. Pomeroy, the boys crawl out of a hole in the ceiling. Do you know where that hole is?
Yes, but I'm not leaving my husband and my daughter here.
Let's take one thing at a time, Mrs. Pomeroy.
No, you don't understand. There's no time for one thing at a time.
I do understand, but you've got to hear me. The fewer hostages we give him, the less leverage he has. The best thing you can do for your husband and your daughter is to get yourself out now.
Lieutenant, he wants to talk to his mom.
Mom?
We need you out here, Mom. Meet Jesse and Jenna.
Oh. You gotta come out, Mom. Mom?
I'm coming out, sweetheart.
Okay, Gene. Where do we stand, Gene? We need to hear from you, Gene. We can't help you.
We have Mrs. Pomeroy coming out. She's coming out.
What the hell is she doing?
Mom, come here!
I've dated more than 1,000 women, and I don't know what it was about you. You're not the most beautiful, and you're not the most, brilliant. But you just had this gentleness about you, and this.
Listen to me, and you listen good. You have no idea what love is. You were the one who didn't love me. To love someone, you have to care about the way they feel and treasure them. You are 100% in the dark about that, and I'm gonna die because of it.
You know what? You really didn't have to end this way. I mean, all I wanted was a house and a little dog. But that can happen now. That can't happen now. It can't exist in this world. My love can't survive this universe. It can't survive this universe. Together in another universe. We'll be together forever. Look at me! Look at me! I want you to see it coming!
No.
If I have to make you suffer, I will. But you will die looking at me.
Questions for you, then we'll go to the hospital.
Jane!
It was quite a gamble you took, Mrs. Pomeroy. You could have gotten yourself killed.
Yeah, well, when it comes to your kids, you do what you have to.